unfortunately got hit by a bout of norovirus. I believe it was norovirus. All I know is I had a stomach bug, and later on found out through talking to people that there had been a stomach virus running through town that took 2 to 3 weeks to run its course, and one day you'd be better and the next day you'd be worse. And it was what people described. I'm like, that's what I had. Because I had been on the medications and was feeling more hopeful, I decided to join my husband on a work trip. For years and years, he's promised me that if he got to go back to Breda, Netherlands for work, that he'd take me, because I'm always complaining that he gets to go to these cool places for work and that I've never been. And I'm such a wanderer. Like, I love travel and hiking and just seeing. I want to see everything on this planet as much as I can. So he said, I have a work trip coming up to Paris and Breda. And part of me just wanted to go so badly. And part of me was terrified because of, you know, the trip. The first trip to Utah in November was rough. And then the one in January was totally like canceled. And so I was super nervous, but he said, you'll be okay. I'll be with you. I'll be there. You've been doing so much better. Let's do this. You know, you need an escape. You need to get away. You need something to look forward to. You need to do something fun. It's been a rough couple months. So I said, okay, let's do it. Thought I was feeling better. But then on the flight out to Paris, it just got worse, like so suddenly. I was really sick. We had to move seats so that I could be on an aisle. I was in a window seat, and I had to keep getting up to go to the bathroom. And so they moved us to the back of the plane so that I could have an aisle seat, but the back of the plane was so turbulent. It was a nightmare. I mean, it was the worst flight, like so bumpy and turbulent, and I'm so queasy. And just, it was rough. Finally, we land, and I think I was so excited to be off the plane and in Paris that I started to feel a little bit better. Miraculously, even though we'd had no sleep because of the time change and we weren't allowed to check into the hotel until later that afternoon, and we were there like 8 in the morning, so we left our luggage at the hotel, and I trekked 4 miles through Paris on no food. I mean, my gut was empty and I couldn't eat anything. We went to a French cafe and I got toast. It was like the worst toast too. I learned how to say in French, thé à la menthe. Is that right? Thé à la menthe. Peppermint tea. I got that everywhere we went. Anyway, halfway through the trip, I got hit with the stomach bug, like full force. Oh, we'd stayed up all night to watch the Super Bowl because the time change, we had to watch the Super Bowl like 3 and 4 in the morning. And I think that kind of made everything kick in again. So I was super duper sick. So I just sat in a hotel room for 2 days. I tried to get out and walk to a nearby pharmacy so that I could get some electrolytes, probiotics, and I almost passed out. So I walked back to my hotel room. It was horrible. It happened to snow in Paris, and it never snows in Paris. And we were trying to catch a train to Amsterdam, and it was standstill traffic. People left their cars on the road and just got out and walked. I mean, it never snows in Paris. Our taxi driver kicked us out of the taxi. Meanwhile, I'm deathly ill, totally dehydrated, and the taxi driver kicks us out in the snow, and we have to haul our luggage for a one-mile walk to this like hostel-type hotel above a restaurant in this village outside of Paris, and no one spoke any English. We had to share the room with my husband's coworker, and again, I'm deathly ill. And then that morning, I'm just sobbing, like, I can't do this. I sent him to the local pharmacy in the village and said, just tell the pharmacist that I'm dehydrated and that I have severe nausea, and you know, bring me back something. So he got me some Voltab or something, an amazing anti-nausea. I want to go back to France just to get this drug. I've looked online to see if I can order it. No, I cannot find this drug, but, and the electrolytes they gave me, I mean, it was for infants, but I felt so much better after taking those. Today, I was able to get on a train and go into, and it was about an hour long train ride, and I got to trek all over Amsterdam, and I felt pretty good. I mean, it was crazy to me. I still couldn't eat that much. I'm relieved that I finally got to enjoy the last day of our trip. You know, do I regret going on that trip? To be that sick in a country that's not your homeland and no one speaks the language, and it was terrifying. But I'm still glad I went, because I did get 2 good days in Paris and 1 good day in Amsterdam, and the flight home was much better, so that was a huge relief. We got back and it was my daughter's 13th birthday, and of course we felt so guilty that we'd been gone for a week, and I wanted to do something amazing for her. So we surprised her with tickets to Hamilton, because she's obsessed. She's got every lyric memorized. She's had it memorized for years. So we surprised her with tickets to Hamilton, and of course they're expensive, so we only got 2, one for her and one for me. And I thought, surely I just trekked all over Amsterdam. I can handle taking the train ride into the city and just walking 15 minutes to a theater where I can sit. Like, I can handle this. As soon as I got off the train, I was very woozy, just got really queasy and anxious and clammy, and was just trying to pull it together for my daughter. It was raining out, and we walked to the theater. First we went to get lunch, and I couldn't eat. I said, let's just go, let's get outside, I can get some fresh air. So we walked, I took a couple pictures in Times Square. We got to the theater, we got in the line, and I just kept trying to breathe, but I was not feeling well at all. Finally, I felt my body get so weak, and I looked at my daughter and said, I'm sorry, I'm going to pass out. And I dropped to one knee. I mean, the ground, it's raining, so I just dropped to a knee in a puddle. And, you know, we're in a line, so it's embarrassing. And the woman standing in line in front of us, she was aware of what was going. She, you know, she picked me up and she told my daughter, you grab one arm and I'll grab the other. And they walked me into the theater and got me into a chair. As they were walking me into the theater, my hearing got very muffled, and my vision started blacking out, and it was just the scariest thing to me, because I'd never passed out before in my life, like never. I did not know what that felt like. Now I know what it feels like to pass out, to lose consciousness. I didn't quite go down, because they got me down into a chair in time, and then I got my head down, so I didn't totally pass out. I went into a hallway and called EMS. EMS came, they took my vitals, they got me into the ambulance to test my blood sugars. My blood sugars were fine, my vitals were fine. At that point I was like, I think I'm okay, and I kind of just wanted to go see the show. They kind of pushed me to go to the emergency room. So, to celebrate my daughter's birthday, we rode in an ambulance to NYU Langone. It was a crazy experience. I mean, emergency rooms are bad. An emergency room in New York City is insane. EKG, that was fine. They took me in the back. They got me hooked up to IV fluids, which I'm sure I needed after 2 weeks of this stomach virus, because I really hadn't eaten. I'd lost a good 5 pounds in 2 weeks. So the fluids were good, but I was in a bed in the hallway. I didn't even know who my doctor was. There were so many people. They're like the top hospital in the nation though, but it was just a nightmare, and my poor husband had to drive all the way into the city. That was definitely a low point because I just thought, I'm supposed to be getting better now. And I've had days where I feel so much better. Why can't I be consistently better? So luckily, the manager of Hamilton was very kind and said, here's my email, we'll get you back. Meanwhile, I continued to fluctuate. For the insomnia, I do take an herbal medicine, we'll leave it at that. With Lyme, it's like you're so tired all the time and yet you can't get to sleep at night. And if you don't get a good night's sleep, it's like so detrimental to how you feel the next day. I mean, I just know if I don't get a good night's sleep, like the next day is gonna be horrible. I do need naps like every day. And my friends make fun of me because they know like I'm a napper, but usually I was a napper because I was getting up at 6 in the morning and teaching 2 classes, like hardcore fitness classes, and training a client and running errands and like doing a lot of stuff that took a lot of energy. And so I like needed a nap. Now I just need naps just because, like for no reason and no workout, sleeping until 8 or 9, I still need naps. Fatigue, the body aches persisted for a long time, especially in my arms. My arms always feel like flu-like. I went back mid-February and he said, give it another month. So I did another month, same medications. He's like, I can see that you're progressing, that you're having this progress. You had that stomach bug. That was a huge setback, but I can see that it's working. So let's stay on these meds because they're working. It's just a little bit slower than we'd like, but they're working. So stick with them. By mid-March, so 1 month later, I was definitely still progressing, but still having bad weeks. I would have like 3 or 4 really awesome days, and then I would relapse and have, you know, 3 really rough days, or even a whole rough week. So it was still too difficult to commit to anything. I couldn't put anything on my calendar. Anything on my schedule is terrifying because I just don't know if I'll be able to do it. I could definitely relapse. I know that I could relapse, but I feel different now. Like, it's not like this is a good day. It's like, this is life. I feel like I'm getting my life back. So every month my fitness supervisor would check in with me and ask, how are you doing? Are you ready to come back to teach your classes? December, that was the first time, mid-December, that relapse was when I said, just cover my classes until January. And that was like a big deal. I remember freaking out so much to give up my classes for 2 weeks. Then January rolled around and I said, okay, cover my classes for 1 more month. Surely I'll be better by February. And when March came and I still wasn't better, I just, you know, I was like, this isn't fair. This isn't fair to the rec. This is too stressful on me to have this pressure to try to be better when I'm not better. And so finally I just said, you know what? Just give my classes to other instructors. I can't keep doing this to you and I can't keep doing this to me. I don't know how long this recovery is gonna be. I've read about people being sick for years, whereas some people are fine in weeks, but I don't know. I don't know. And it's not fair to keep dragging this out or to keep getting subs. And so finally I gave up my classes and, you know, of course I started to have more and more good days after that. And I was like kind of wanting to hit myself, but I still know that that's the right thing, that I had to do that, but it was hard. One of the things with Lyme that they ask is, are you sad? Do you cry? Yes, I definitely have been sad a lot and I have cried so much more. Part of that is the Lyme. I think part of that is just normal. When you lose your health, lose your job, lose your purpose, lose your identity, you're gonna be sad and you're gonna cry. It's a loss. It's a loss of self. It's like losing a loved one. So definitely, like, there's sadness. At the same time, I try to just always be grateful. So it was hard because, you know, you don't want to be sad, but you just are. You need to mourn the losses that you're experiencing. But then I would read about so many other people who were worse, like so much worse, in stage 2 Lyme and chronic Lyme. And then I couldn't help but just be grateful that I wasn't that bad. I'm still alive. I'm still, like, here and present for my family. Some days I feel good enough to go on a walk or to go out to eat or to do simple things. Like, some days I could do housework just fine. So I had to be grateful for those things. I always said it could be worse, it could be worse. At the same time, I had to acknowledge and respect the fact that I had to mourn, that that's natural, and I had to honor those feelings and own my frustration and not berate myself. April 1st, and I have finally had almost a full week of feeling good. And the past few days, I felt almost normal, almost like my old self. I went to the facility that I teach at and was able to work out in the weight room and do some cardio on a spin bike, and I survived. And I was so excited. I was able to do some pull-ups and strength training, and I just was so happy because I had glimpses of myself. And finally, for the first time in 4 or 5 months, felt like I might get better. I might actually heal